Hello. We are glad to have this opportunity to briefly present our research results unraveling the molecular mechanism of skin toxicity to the cancer drugs, epidermal growth factor receptor, and MEK inhibitors. Many cancers, including lung, colorectal, and head and neck cancers, benefit from exacerbated epidermal growth factor receptor, or EGFR, activity for their growth and survival, and others, such as melanoma, from exacerbated MEK activity. Therefore, agents targeting the EGFR and MEK signaling pathways are increasingly used for the treatment of cancers. One significant clinical limitation to the prolonged use of EGFR and MEK inhibitors is the occurrence of skin toxicity in 50 to 80% of patients, including most frequently an acneiform eruption that unfortunately usually already develops within the first few weeks of therapy. Importantly, the development and severity of the acneiform eruption has been shown to correlate with favorable anti-tumor responses. Under the microscope, acneiform eruption lesions are characterized by a folliculitis with massive infiltration of neutrophils histologically resembling acne vulgaris. Another feature of acneiform toxicities caused by EGFR and MEK inhibitors is the topographical predominance of inflammation in skin areas rich in pilosebaceous units, also corresponding to sebum-rich regions of the skin, such as the face, upper chest, and back, which is a shared feature with the common skin disease acne vulgaris. These sebum-rich regions are highly colonized by Cutibacterium acnes, formerly known as Propionibacterium acnes, a commensal bacteria representing the most abundant microorganism on the skin of healthy adults.
Hello. To understand the pathogenesis of the acneiform skin toxicity to EGFR and MEK inhibitor, we perform gene expression profiling of lesional skin biopsy samples from patients suffering from the acneiform eruption. We found strongly elevated IL-8 and IL-36γ in patient skin compared to skin from healthy donors, whereas TNF, IL-17 and IL-6, other important inflammatory cytokines, were not significantly upregulated. This observation was further confirmed by quantitative PCR in a larger number of skin samples. IL-36γ is a pro-inflammatory cytokine and is belong to the IL-1 family and is able to signal in an auto or paracrine manner through the IL-36 receptor, activating downstream NF-kappa B signaling in target cells. To define which types of cells express IL-36γ in the skin of patients with acneiform eruption, we performed in situ hybridization and immunohistochemistry. We found that elevated IL-36γ expression was predominantly localized to keratinocytes of hair follicles within affected skin. To examine whether EGFR inhibition could lead to enhanced IL-36γ production in keratinocytes, we exposed primary human keratinocytes to EGFR inhibitor erlotinib in the presence or absence of C. acnes, commensal bacterium that colonizes sebum-rich skin. Interestingly, IL-36γ production was synergistically enhanced only when keratinocytes were simultaneously exposed to EGFR inhibitor and C. acnes. In contrast, like TNF, IL-1β and IL-6, other important inflammatory cytokines were not significantly increased in the same settings. In an ex vivo skin model, we could further show that neutrophilic chemoattractant and IL-8 was induced in an IL-36 receptor-dependent manner after EGFR inhibitor and PAM3-CSK4, that is TL2 agonist, similar to C. acnes. By means of IL-36γ promoter analysis, by mutagenesis and luciferase reporter assays, followed by a transcription factor database search, we could identify KLF4 as a transcription factor that activates IL-36γ transcription downstream of the EGFR-MEK pathway. We could confirm the binding of KLF4 into the IL-36γ promoter using MSAL and DNA pull-down assays. We could demonstrate the requirement of KLF4 for the transcriptional activation of IL-36γ by overexpressing wild-type and mutant KLF4 and by shRNA knockdown of KLF4. Lastly, by mutagenesis of the KLF4 binding site in the IL-36γ promoter by CRISPR-Cas9, we observed much less IL-36γ transcriptional activity, confirming the crucial role of KD4 downstream of EGFR MEK pathway.
In conclusion, the research data generated by my research group, including first author Dr. Takashi Satoh, demonstrate that EGFR and MEK inhibitors partner with the commensal bacterium Cutibacterium acnes that colonizes sebum-rich skin to synergistically and potently induce keratinocyte IL-36γ expression and subsequently drive IL-8-mediated neutrophil-rich inflammation in an experimental ex vivo setting. The requirement of an NF-kappa B signal provided by Cutibacterium acnes via tolereceptor 2 explains the characteristic topographical distribution of the acneiform skin toxicity to sebum-rich regions of the skin known to be densely populated with pilosebaceous units and Cutibacterium acnes, such as the central face, upper chest, and back. IL-36 has been demonstrated to form a self-amplifying inflammatory loop in keratinocytes which express high levels of the IL-36 receptor. The data presented here provide substantial evidence that acneiform skin toxicity caused by EGFR and MEK inhibitors should be added to the growing list of pustular skin diseases in which IL-36 likely plays a central pathogenic role. Our findings provide a basis for investigating the potential of therapies targeting the IL-36 pathway in acneiform skin toxicity caused by EGFR and MEK inhibitors.